across a little bit.
Okay. I kind of wondered about that.
What's that?
I kind of wondered about that. This is her cuter side. Jeez, I gotta really back up. Kind of a funny picture.
So that's fetal liver. The shadows are ribs.
So all those little lines are
ribs. Traces the heart sounds. We can get an idea of the heart rate.
Just tell me if I'm in the way.
Based on that.
Oh, I see, that's cool. That heart measurement, then you'll be able to tell it. Because the sire's 14.3, and she's 15, and so. I think of that as an average size horse, but around Montana, it's like a small, really small horse.
Extra fluid around the fetus, or extra fluid, so amniotic fluid versus allantoic fluid. I don't see anything that makes me suspicious of that. Okay, I'll take you around. As far as uterine health, placental health, and fetal health, everything looks pretty good. The other issue that can be is a ruptured prepubic tendon, which actually is what supports the uterus and everything. And they can't handle it over time. So that's also something to note is how much she's changed over time, if she does change over time. The best way to do that is if you have one of the weight tapes. It's like an inches marker. And put it around her when you get home. Write that down on your calendar. 2 days from now, do it again. And just make sure that it's not changing in big increments.
So the same place that I would measure her regular weight, or around the belly?
Measure around the belly.
Okay.
Right almost.
Okay.
And that'll give us a bit of an idea if she's scattered her game. It's a little bit of a it's one of those things that doesn't happen very often. When it does happen, it can be a big problem. So see her belly start getting closer and closer and closer to the ground, rather than getting bigger and bigger around. And that's something that she needs support. Sometimes those mares can't push, so they need assistance in getting the foal out. I think she just has a big foal. She's the one that we're trying to mare, and she's just bigger than she ones. Yeah, and it's good.
That was her second one. We thought we should change her name to Ginormica.
That would be a little more fitting, wouldn't it?
Do you know where those